Are you wondering if engineering is right for you? Well, in this video, we talk about the top 10 personal attributes that are critical for engineering success. Hey, 1% Nation, I'm Jake Voorhees, and you are watching episode 33 of the 1% Engineer Show, where we empower young engineers to rise to the top 1% of their career. If this is your first time to the channel, make sure you subscribe because I release videos for young engineers on Wednesdays and Saturdays, so you don't want to miss out on that. Particularly at the beginning, but sometimes in the middle and latter portions as well, many students question if engineering is right for them, if they will be a good engineer, things like this. So I made this video to talk about the top 10 attributes, likes, characteristics, and things like this, so you can decide if you're on the right path, so you can decide if you're a good engineer. So let's jump right into it and not miss any time, guys, with number one, curiosity and analytical mind. Engineers should always be questioning the world, wondering why things are this way, wondering how things work, wondering how buildings stand up, or how software code works, or how a biomedical invention is actually operational. So if you're not curious and you're not always striving to figure out how things work and wanting to dig deeper into problems, because you have to be able to fundamentally understand lots of little intricacies about things in order to problem solve, in order to design. So you have to be a curious person. Two, math and science. There's an incredible amount of math and science in engineering. So you have to be good at it. Not only that, but you have to like it. You have to be able to deploy that curiosity. You have to be able to deploy your student habits to all this math and science. So you just have to have a strong liking for it. I get this question a lot. Can I still be an engineer if I'm not good at math, if I don't like math? The answer is no. Three, are you a serious student? Are you committed to your work? Because this is going to apply not only in your university days, but into your professional career. You really have to be serious about your job later on. You really have to be serious about all of your classes, your studies, your projects, your relationships with your professors, your labs, everything. Because engineering just requires more work than a lot of other fields. So unless you're really into the material, unless you're into the coursework, unless you're into your job, your internships later on, then you're not going to be successful. You really have to be all in engineering. So this is required. You have to be a good student. You have to be serious. Four, be a good problem solver. Problem solving is the essence of engineering. We're trying to figure out how things went wrong so we can improve them for the future, so we can constantly be evolving our infrastructure, our inventions, our software applications, our energy, whatever it may be that is your niche in engineering. You're always going to be problem solving. And that starts at the beginning of your university road when you're talking about homework problems, exam problems, and all the way throughout your career, you're trying to figure something out. You're trying to make it better. You're trying to figure out why something failed in order to improve it. That is the essence of engineering. You have to be a good problem solver, guys. Five, attention to detail. Many times, engineering problems, engineering solutions, engineering critical thinking involves lots of minute details that comprise a total picture. So you have to be able to have very strong attention to little details, because if one thing is out of place, if one conversion is missed, if a single step in a long process of equations or design or software code is missed, if a single thing is omitted, the entire thing is going to fail. So you have to have a very, very strong attention to detail. You can't be lazy. You can't just say, oh, well, I looked it over once, it's going to be fine. No, you have to double check. You have to triple check your stuff. So being willing, being able, being attracted to fine-tuned detail, strong attention to detail skills is mandatory. Six, creativity. This one is subject to a little bit of debate because engineers are notorious and oftentimes stereotyped as being very far left-brained. But the reality is, lots of times in the problem-solving approach, you have to be creative. You have to think outside of the box. You have to be willing to do something that may not have ever been done before in order to solve a unique problem, in order to think of the best solutions within a cost-effective fashion or maybe a time-restricted fashion. So you have to be creative. You have to be able to go against the grain sometimes in engineering. So creativity is a massive, massively strong attribute. Seven, spatial awareness. Oftentimes engineers are given a three-dimensional problem or something where they may just be working with code, or they may just be working in a petri dish doing some research or something like this. But the greater schema, the greater type of problem that they're working on is something like a massive building or a realistic problem. For example, you could be writing a software application for something that actually happens in a grocery store, actually happens in a factory line. And you have to be able to envision this problem, envision the application for what you're working on in the real world. So many times engineers have a good three-dimensional brain. They can see something in a two-dimensional page. They can just look at code and they can envision what this thing would look like in the real world. So a knack for spatial awareness is pretty strong. 8, you have to be a good team player. There's very few situations in this world where a single engineer can accomplish anything. Me, myself personally, as a civil engineer, we are always working in massive teams. I'm transportation, we are often working with bridge people, environmental people, architects, construction, survey people. So you have to be a good team player. You have to be able to do your task and communicate well to other people and just be a good team member, be supportive of others who are struggling, be empathetic to these situations. You just have to be able to work as one cog in this bigger overall machine. That's crazy important, guys. You have to excel in teamwork environments. 9, technical knowledge. Engineering is rife with software applications and conversions and a long list of mathematical, science, statistical and overall materials and whatever niche and other practical knowledge that is required for your field. You have to know a lot of stuff about a lot of stuff, and it's not subjective. It's not a philosophical world. It's not a entirely creative world where, for example, an artist doesn't necessarily need to know a lot of technical knowledge. As long as they have that talent, they can succeed. But as an engineer, you need to know a lot of stuff about software, science, math, and all of these technical areas. So you have to be a tactician in technical skills, guys. And 10, I save this one for last because I do believe it is often omitted, yet it is the most powerful attribute. If you can be a good communicator, you are going to win in engineering. Just like talking about team players, oftentimes the leaders, the managers, the CEOs of companies are not only good engineers and good team players, but they can communicate as well. And if you can take the mic, if you can present, if you can speak in front of your group, even in an internal fashion, you're gonna win, you're gonna shine. So I cannot stress this enough, guys. The best engineers in this world have really strong oral and written communication. They know how to deal with technical writing. They know how to deal with team management and working in groups and using that communication, whether it be speaking, whether it be written, whether it be just casual water cooler, developing good relationships with your colleagues, developing good relationships with your clients. We live in a world where communication and your ability to deal with people is a highlight attribute. So those that are strong communicators win in life. And engineering is no different. So those are my top 10 personal attributes for engineering success, guys. So you can decide if engineering is right for you and you're gonna be able to crush it in your career. Comment below about which of these skills you think is the strongest in engineering and which of them that you're working on right now in your engineering journey. If you like this video, guys, consider subscribing because I release videos on Wednesdays and Saturdays for young engineers so you can crush it in your career and become a 1% engineer.